It's Don Marnell, the man who turns cats into cats. In 2016, I had the pleasure of joining the OTT family. Alongside the great Angus Old McAnally, we formed the very first OTT commentary team. And over the years, we got to call all the action in a wonderful, magical, historic, legendary building known as the Tivoli Theatre. So I thought, while we're all locked away in our own homes, what better time than now to share with you some of my favorite encounters from the Tivoli Theatre. There'll be laughter, there'll be tears, there'll be blood, there'll be beers, and there was so much action that we had to split this into two parts. So watch along with me, crack a beer, crack three, as we enjoy the gems of the Tivoli. Our first matchup is one of my all-time favorite OTT encounters. We're kicking things off with a bang! And we're going all the way back to June 4th, 2017, at OTT Outer Space Odyssey 3, Stranger Things Have Happened. You see, at OTT, we've always liked to think outside the box, do things that little bit differently. And that includes the most basic of match stipulations. You see, the one thing that every six-person tag team match usually has in common is that it has six people. But when Angel Cruz, his then partner B Cool, and his former tag team partner Tyler Bate were set to team up against another team, things got a little bit confusing when there was, well, a common denominator. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the Angel Cruisers and Tyler Bate versus Pete Dunne, Trent Seven, and Tyler Bate. Let's kick things off.
Be here, I know you will.
He's here!
Tyler!
How's it going?
Good,
bro. Long time no see.
Yeah. Sorry about the title. It's a bummer. Yeah. This will cheer you up, though. Guess you're tag team inside of it. On the old Angel Cruz. Huh? We're the six-man tag team tonight.
Okay. Who's up walking?
There he is over there, actually. See? He's kind of scooped.
Who
are we fighting?
Yeah.
Probably the worst tag team to ever come along in a long while, I think. Tonight, the team of Angel Cruz, Tyler Breeze, and Be Cool are going to wipe the floor of British Strong Style.
Tyler Breeze, yeah. Is fine, that's a good coup. So, me, Tyler, Pete, against you, Tyler Breeze, might have to find from now. See if he's doing it. And this nutbag. So, let's do it.
Do you want to go talk tactics, sir?
See, that's what we do.
If you could see me and Tyler again, I would take my hand off your shoulders. With a weapon.
Not with a weapon.
With a blade.
Yeah. Not your own hands. Because you're not mad enough. You stay away from my last time, sister.
What are you doing?
What's that Pete done?
She did the goddamn on the
Get nasty, Cruz! I'm gonna get me an autograph!
Here we go, Angel! For the first time in pro wrestling history, Tyler Bate and Tyler Breeze are about to share a ring.
No, I don't. I'll explain it to you after.
Atmosphere. The last time British Strong Style were all together in an OTT arena, it's still being talked about as being one of the most intense moments in OTT history.
If this is half as memorable, we're in for a treat. Where's Tyler Bate? The most dominant OTT champ in history, Pete Dunne, standing proud. And you look at these three men. Talk about enjoying your success. No one is enjoying their success anywhere near as much as British Strong Style are right now.
But they're doing it together. Oh, wait a second, hang on. Well, they're missing somebody. They're missing somebody here. Is it not? Hang on, Pete's there. And Trent is there, but where's Tyler?
We've got British. Strong, where's Style?
Tyler, okay, who's got Tyler?
Going down, Don. I think that match only has one winner, and that's Tyler. The word triple comes to mind because there's three of them. Well, this pre-match hydration ritual, I gotta get behind this.
If you want to play the numbers game. Oh no! Team Brick being taken out by the Bruiserweight. Big Cool is down.
I think Tyler knows whose team he wants to be on now. Well, if you had a choice.
Oh no!
Team and with no a second.
There's no need for this, Pete!
Team and with the Bruiserweight and Trent Seven are going against the Bruiserweight and Trent Seven. All credit to Angel Cruz and Be Cool, but I would not want to face that duo.
Oh no, Team Prick!
Angel Cruz threatening to murder Trent Seven.
Hell hath no fury like an ultra star scorned.
Tyler Breeze, Tyler Bate, being encouraged to pick a side.
It's Sophie's choice. It's Sophie's choice, Don. Can anyone follow the action?
Well, Pete Dunne is over here throwing fans around like no one's business. Trent Seven is beating the hell out of Team Prick.
The rolling attack from Pete Dunne.
Gentleman has been involved in quite a few matches this evening. Almost as many as Tyler Bate.
Is the chance.
Trent Seven is intent on killing Team Prick. The Bruiserweight sporting the blazer.
Extra medium, of course.
The blazer weight, Pete Dunne. Hang on a second. We saw you dress like Team Prick earlier, Angle.
It's very much in vogue. I hope their boss doesn't see that. Would you say there's no chance in hell he'll see it, Don?
I think there's a strong chance he's going to see it.
Stunners all around!
Simply stunning! Cruz aware that Tyler even has a choice. He seems oblivious to the fact that Tyler even teams with Pete and Trent. We've seen these two, Be Cool and Tyler Bate, the two best squatters in OTT, have squat offs before. What is that?
So many times now, communication within a tag team is crucial.
Be Cool may have just swung the balance. Trent Seven is still wearing that blazer.
Who is Tyler going to tag in?
You call the Tyler, and we'll call the Tyler, and we'll see who he comes to. Tagged in Trent Seven.
Angel is emotionally hurt.
Team Prick.
Peter and Rick here.
This could be the making of them.
Fuck that young bucks.
Oh, what's Angel doing?
He's hurt. He's upset.
He's upset. He's going for something. Maybe getting a steel chair, even up the odds.
Well, we've seen him pull a blade in a match before.
Oh my God!
He's got an axe! Angel Cruz has got an axe!
Here's Angel!
He said earlier he would take Brent Seven's head off his body.
Angel Cruz.
Angel Cruz is a man of his word. He's put a goddamn axe into the ring. Do not bring a bottle of water to an axe fight.
He swore he was going to do it. He said if Trent ever came between him and Tyler again.
His boss likes a sledgehammer. Seven is exactly where Angel Cruz wants him. Shades of the French Revolution.
What are you enough for?
What?
The Tyler wants in on Team Angel and Be Cool. Be Cool legal. Let's not forget, this is former OTT NLW champ versus former OTT tag team champ.
Pete Dunne's going up for the ride. Yeah, always support the lower back. Safer for everyone. That's just sensible lifting practice.
Sweet tag.
coming up just short. No. And that's why we call him the best in the business. We saw Chris Wolf, we saw Moose. Now we see the Fox. WWE UK champ is in the ring. Biggest reaction goes to our referee.
Should Foxy maybe not have DQ'd himself for outside interference? I'm struggling to follow what's going on here.
If a referee hits a brainbuster in the woods and no one's there to pin it.
Who's on his team? Is Foxy the sixth man?
Stranger Things Have Happened is the title of this show.
They haven't. These fans are changing favorites seemingly with every move.
Vintage Pete Dunne.
Now he's on both teams. Why you gotta look at him?
Tyler Bate, stroke, Tyler Breeze.
Oh! I couldn't handle seeing Tyler hit Angel. Please don't say this is gonna happen.
Don't do it, Tyler.
Sorry, he loves him, but Tyler, no!
Don't look at the hand, Angel! Don't look at the hand, Angel!
What? Oh, I got
airplane spin!
Maybe some resentment showing here. Remember, Pete took Tyler's title.
No.
Oh, my God.
Even Tyler can't do this. That airplane spin nearly sent Pete Dunne back to Orlando.
Oh!
Andy and Liz, Edge and Lita, the great couples of pro wrestling over the years. Nothing compares to this. Hey, just be cool.
Angel is losing the plot.
He's on self-destruct mode here, Don. This is why parents don't let their kids watch wrestling.
Wait a second! Team Brick have just become Team Pete! Those guys are old enough to drink.
What are we seeing? Pedigree! Pedigree to Trips!
Cheer on the Bruiserweight as he hits the Pedigree on his own partner. While his other partner, who's also his opponent, rests up on the side of the ring. Mayhem.
Oh no.
No! Double pedigree!
The man who made his name in OTT's come home, but what's Tyler doing?
Tyler's on a free roll anyway, he's a winner. Tyler's on Team Tyler, that's it.
Driver 97 to the Overstar. And that's how you send a breakup text.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, British Strong Style.
Fairly certain you can get locked up for that angle. But nonetheless, Tyler Bate couldn't lose tonight. But the teammates of his standing strong are his British Strong Style compatriots. Referee now, Fox, special shout out to him. Hitting the brainbuster on Be Cool. Team Prince just hit and completed puberty all in one match. And the Ultra Star Angel crew as well. He'll live to fight another day.
Something I've said to you a handful of times over the years here, Don. What the hell did we just see?
Love is a lie, it 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 is a lie
we've had some magical nights here, Don. This makes the biscuit. And I've said it once or twice already tonight. This isn't even the main event.
October 2016 was an instrumental weekend in the history of OTT as we held a three-night extravaganza known as WrestleCon. Now at that time there was a man that called himself the king of OTT, the controversial Ryan Smile, and he wanted to take on the biggest name import that we could get. Well, it just so happened that on night one of WrestleCon in the Tivoli Theatre, Ryan Smile took on Chris Hero. It's a sleeper match and potentially one of the most underrated OTT matches in history. So, Ryan Smile versus Chris Hero, October 2016. Let's have a look.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is set for Unfall! Introducing to the ring first!
As a pure wrestling fan angle, I cannot wait to see what happens when Ryan Smile goes face to face with Chris Hero here in the Tivoli. This is going to be 5-star by anybody's standards.
The chant of "Yes We Can" rings out around the sold out Tivoli. Ryan Smile is one of our own. He's been here since day one. He is such an integral part in the machine that has built OTT. Month in, month out, Ryan Smile is here. This crowd has taken him to their hearts. And they want to see him get the win here tonight against one of the best in the world.
And introducing to the ring, his opponent.
He might be their hero, but is he Chris Hero?
Awesome.
artist, one of the greatest of all time, no matter who you ask. And he's right here at OTT in the Tivoli, taking on fan favourite Ryan Smile. If you've never seen a Chris Hero match, what the hell are you doing with your life? This man is absolutely insane. And I've got goosebumps here waiting to see what happens in this match.
Arguably the most highly regarded independent wrestler in the world. If you were to survey all 500 plus of the fans here tonight, Don, and in fact, if you were to survey most of the OTT roster, number one on their list of wrestlers they'd like to have here at OTT, number one is going to be that man, Chris Hero.
Fitting that we have him here at WrestleCon. The last time I saw Chris Hero live was at WrestleCon 2 years ago. He stole the show that night, and now he's come all the way to Ireland to steal it again.
Can the all-day star fly Smile high tonight? Or will the knockout artist put Ryan Smile back in his place as Chris Hero makes his debut in OTT?
Chris Hero is about to see what an Irish wrestling crowd is all about. Seems split here. It's almost like, you know, Ryan Smile's like the girlfriend we've had for 2 years, but with this amazing chick comes along. Let's call her Christina Hero. And it's like, who am I going to go for? Loyalty or this new exciting thing that we've heard so much about?
If you're a fan of independent wrestling, you are in for such a treat.
Dream match on the first of two nights here at WrestleCon. On the merch stand, the guys selling t-shirts over there are standing on the tables just so they can see this match. Nobody wants to miss it. The guy cleaning the toilet just stepped out to watch this match. Everybody wants to see Smile versus Hero.
Of styles here, Don. The high-flying aerial ability of Ryan Smile versus that brutal knockout power of Chris Hero.
How do you think Smile's going to react to not being the fan favorite tonight? I don't think that's happened before here at OTT. Not for Ryan. Jerry Humperdin comes out and makes this a triple threat match, this place will have the roof blown off it.
Well, I like to say he's the man to manage the mayhem here. There is total respect for referee Niall Fox throughout the OTT roster.
Smile versus Hero, who's going to win? Swerve, Foxy.
Good night, good luck. Ryan Smile, right. Chris Hero go home.
5-star.
Leaving Niall Fox standing 5-star. In the center of the ring to the adoring chants of this bonkers OTT audience.
You can never predict what's going to happen here in the Tivoli.
WrestleCon, the biggest night in Irish wrestling history, and the biggest pop goes not to X-Pac, not to Chris Hero, but to referee Niall Fox.
Oh, man, you gotta love OTT crowds. Chris Hero standing there going, this is easy.
Now, before I fuck you up, before you fuck me up,
remember that split crowd we had?
Means business. The time for playing around, the time for dueling chants is over. Chris Hero came to win.
Well, I know I'm not shaking your hand again, mister. You've ruined that now. There needs to be trust. Roll him up, Hero, roll him up.
Roll him up, Hero, roll him up.
I think they want to see some wrestling now.
I said no.
Hero working that wrist lock, feeling out Ryan's smile.
That's a good way to start off. See what Ryan Smiles' mentality is like. What's he going to come back at him with? And he's going to come back by doing repeated keep-ups.
I don't know how kindly Chris Hero is going to take to that level of showboating.
You don't see the second rope lie on too often. Bat on early. We see him hit this in a lot of different ways.
Torquing on that neck of Ryan Smile.
Chris Hero known for that hold, the cravat. Like I said, he can hit it in many different ways. He can slam you. He can end matches just with this. Into a snapmare.
Unconventional takeover.
Chris Hero right now is playing a game of human chess with Ryan Small. See what Ryan can come back at him with. He'll feel out his opponent. It's always important after all the fun and games, after all the chatting, if you want to win the match, you've got to figure out what your opponent's bringing to the table.
Ryan Small finding a way out with a wrist lock of his own. Transitions the hammerlock and around to the headlock. Hero shoots him off the ropes. Eats a shoulder tackle for his trouble. But to minimal effect.
Oh,
Toreador warms up.
It's not often you see a competitor invite a shoulder tackle from his opponent, but Hero seems confident. And with good reason.
Smile deciding to go for one more. I don't know how wisely that is, though, Don.
This is fine for Chris Hero. He could do this all night.
This ain't working, so fuck that. How about you, Don?
I don't think that's such a good idea from Smile, but let's see how this turns out.
I would knock you over.
I don't know if Ryan Smile paid attention in physics class, but if an object with that much mass is coming at you at that kind of velocity, you're in for a world of hurt. Ryan Smile's out. Ryan Smile's out.
Chris Hero loves to do that. Ryan Smile's prepping himself for one kind of impact, and then he hits him with a completely different move.
There's your second rope lieback. Ryan Smile's out. He just got his head kicked off.
Ryan Smile still thinks it's the first ever OTT. Years ago, he has no idea where he is right now. And yes, Chris Hero ain't nothing to fuck with.
I don't know if that's slapping Ryan Smile to antagonize him, or just to wake him up and bring him around. Smile, leapfrog. And again, hits the rope, ducks the shot, ducks the back elbow, and the flying shoulder tackle is enough.
Wow. Ryan Smile using the speed to his advantage now. That is how he's going to be successful in this match. You're going to play to your strengths, minimize Chris Hero's.
The speed and agility of Ryan Smile is key against the technically proficient bigger man, Chris Hero. Oh!
A huge knee. Ryan comes off the apron on the outside, the barricade even. Hero's got the upper hand in this match. Now, the difference between this and the last match, there are countouts here.
Certainly are. Ryan Smile's going to need to recuperate and recover pretty quickly. Because Chris Hero's literally letting his hair down, and that can't spell anything good for Ryan Smile.
Oh my God, what a strike. The thing about Chris Hero is through his career, he's figured out a way to hit offense from almost any situation, any position. Innovation isn't the word.
And that one had to sting. Smile in the crowd and then nearly kicking his head clean off.
Chris Hero, is he hitting the bar already? Hey, grab me one of them, will you?
A man after your own heart, Don, but he still has a job to do here. Ryan Smile ain't finished yet. Hero rolling into the ring to break that count.
He can keep up too.
He's nimble for a big guy.
Oh, wait a second.
Ryan Smile's on a four count here.
Foxy's stealing the show with his count out here, just like we knew he wouldn't this match.
Ryan Smile's still not back. We're at it. Just gone past a seven count. That's eight, Don. This match could end right now.
Oh, just by the skin of his teeth.
9 3/4.
The fact that Ryan stayed on his feet even for a moment after that forearm is fucking amazing.
And the fact that he still has the wherewithal to kick out of that pin. There's a determination in Ryan's smile that you don't see in too many athletes. Centaur!
Well, I said this earlier, if Ryan wants to be successful here, he's got to play at his own pace.
He's got to try and speed up the match. Chris Hero is now picking his spots. He's absolutely dissecting Ryan. And if he continues like this, it's going to be over pretty quick. See, that's the thing. Normally Ryan will get a lot of support from the crowd. He'll be able to feed off that, be energized by that. But if he can't get that this time, if half the crowd is chanting for Hero, does he have it within him?
Smile driven face first into that big boot of Chris Hero.
That one went through Ryan. Chris Hero was aiming about 3 feet behind Ryan. Ryan was just in the way of where he was aiming.
That's the kind of chop that emits a shockwave that pulses through your heart and lungs. God damn it, that'll put hair on your chest. Ryan Smile with some strikes of his own.
Starting back now. Oh, some kicks of Ryan's own.
Just like you said, Don. Ryan Smile speeding up proceedings.
He needs to pick up
getting
the
upper hand.
This is crucial. He needs to keep this going. Build that momentum. Stay on Chris. Don't
running
let him let up for a
running
second.
Uppercut.
And now it's Hero to the outside.
Oh no.
Oh wait a second.
What is Ryan Smile planning?
You know he's got a pace. There's something else that Ryan's got in the locker too. Huge kick to Hero on the outside. Springboard! Moonsault! Oh my god!
Ryan Smile putting his body on the line, doing whatever it takes to get the win here at OTT against Chris Hero. Smile running to the corner. He's up!
Oh! Fly, Ryan, fly! But it's Hero who gets back to the ring first. Maybe that took more out of Smile than it did out of Hero.
Flying Smile high with Ryanair. That leap of faith over the corner turnbuckle. Blatant disregard for his own safety. Ryan Smile's out for a win, and a win at all costs.
Ryan's taking his time going to the top here. This could cost him. Trying to get the crowd back on his side the way he's used to.
Chris Hero lying prone in the center of this ring.
Hero's smart. He's a veteran of the game. But he put himself in a precarious position. Smile took advantage. Oh my god!
It's over.
Knock him low!
Ryan Smile kicks out.
That all happened in a flash. The turnaround of offense there was insane. I thought that was it for sure.
Both men with devastating head kicks.
We've seen strikers like Tommy End work OTT matches before, but this is as good as anything we've seen as regards strikes.
Well, they don't call him the knockout artist for nothing, Don. He is a world-class striker. And he can put you away at any moment.
Let's go, Hero! Ryan Smile! Let's go, Hero! Ryan Smile! Let's go, Hero! Ryan Smile! Let's go, Hero! Ryan Smile!
Oh no!
Could be a tombstone pile driver.
Ryan rolls through! Hero just finds a way out.
The look on Chris's face says it all.
There's really? A confidence here for Chris Hero. He thinks he's not going anywhere.
Yes, determined, if nothing else, his smile. Another look on Smile's face tells the story. He's going, I've hit you with pretty much everything I've got in the locker. What's he going to take to put Hero away?
Ryan Smile got him up. That's almost a victory in itself. Listen to the reaction of this sold-out crowd, Don.
Whether they're supporting Hero, whether they're supporting Smile, not one person at the bar, nobody taking a bathroom break. Everybody's eyes are glued on this instant classic.
Smile attempting the suplex here. Has he the power to get Chris Hero up?
Smart from Hero. He goes to the knee. You can't lift dead weight. Oh, wait. Pop and pile driver from Chris Hero.
No.
And another kick out from Ryan Smile.
Niall Fox on top of the action with the accurate call, saying Ryan Smile had his shoulder up. And it was clear to see from this vantage point that he did. Miraculously he did. Unbelievably he did. He got the shoulder up.
I love WrestleCon, Ango. I love WrestleCon. And this is only night one.
Smile blocking the effort from Chris Hero. Oh!
Straight shot.
Smile down to one knee. Chris Hero back in control of this match. But Ryan Smile is blocking it again. Don, I don't care who you are. You can't take too many of those shots. Most human beings can't even take one.
No! Oh my God! What a reversal from Ryan Smile. The crowd's on their feet.
But Ryan doesn't have it in it to make the cover.
Oh, he's feeding off it now. He goes for the pin. One, two. Oh my God! Are we going to tell the rest of the workers that there are no more matches tonight? Because this is going on until we're kicked out of the Tivoli. It's going on until tomorrow.
I am genuinely speechless here, Don.
That's never happened before.
You know, you talk about your Pete Dunne versus Luther Ward matches. You talk about all the huge fights we've seen in an OTT ring. I genuinely don't know we've ever had a crowd this engaged in a match before in the two-year history of OTT.
We've never had
this
one more.
This is the second anniversary.
That.
We are putting it all on the line.
Oh, no.
Heroes caught him. Heroes caught him.
Backslide.
Not enough. Oh no, he's caught him again.
Could this be it? Smile fights out of it.
Off the ropes. Jumps up. Oh no.
He's caught. Oh wait. Oh wait. This spells nothing good for
this
Smile.
This is dangerous. This is dangerous. Don't do it.
Oh. One, two. Smile has taken absolutely everything that Hero has to offer. I don't think he packed more with him. He's got nothing left. That's got to be it.
The gas tank is empty, Don. The gas tank is empty. Ryan Smile, as he does every month, has given his all for this OTT crowd. He hasn't an ounce of energy left to get back up off the mat. Listen to this crowd, Don.
The crowd are getting tired just watching this match. Thank God they've got cans.
Niall Fox has started the count on Ryan Smile here.
And Hero's
encouraging. And I'll be dead straight. I don't know that Ryan Smile will be able to answer the 10 count here.
This tells you everything you need to know. Hero is waiting to see if Smile can get up. He'd be happy if he won by count out.
Hero hasn't any choice. He's tapped of energy himself.
Come on, Hero.
Oh, my God. Almost as if it's pained him to do it. He doesn't want to needlessly hurt Ryan Smile. But the problem is, if you want to put Ryan Smile away, you're going to have to damn near kill him.
We don't have to stay down.
Uptown Funk rings out around the Tivoli. This crowd is back behind their local hero, Ryan Smile. But is it too little too late? That back elbow says no.
Oh my God! Oh my God, they are trading big boots.
He hits the cutter! Springboard cutter! Ryan's not going for the pin!
Listen to this crowd angle.
Ryan Smile wants another piece of Chris Hero. He's not happy to put him away yet. I don't know if it's wise, but it certainly shows some balls. Up top.
Oh, he's got him. He's got him in the cravat. He's got him in the cravat hold. And a slam.
And he dumps him on his head.
Oh. If there was any taste left in Ryan's mouth, it's gone now. Zero calling for the end. There it is. That's got to be it. Amazing. What a match. What a match, Angle. Ryan Smile gave it absolutely everything he had, but he just by the thinnest of margins came up short to international superstar Chris Hero. This crowd is on their feet, not for the winner Hero, but for both men. They put on a masterclass here in the Tivoli tonight on the first night of OTT's second anniversary WrestleCon.
It took every single weapon in the arsenal of Chris Hero to put away Ryan Smile. He took every single shot and kept coming back for more. You know they say it's not about how hard you can hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. Ryan Smile is the living embodiment of that fighter spirit. Ryan Smile is the living embodiment of the warrior spirit. And it took everything Chris Hero had to get that win tonight. Respect to Chris Hero, but my God, respect to Ryan Smile too.
Look at this, nobody's sitting down, Angle. Everybody's up. What a match, what a crowd, what an event, what a venue.
The OTT wrestling fans are a breed apart, every one of them on their feet, celebrating what may just be the best match we've ever seen inside an OTT ring.
That's on every DVD highlight reel. Now, so whenever we stop this crazy journey.
Here he comes. Hey, this isn't a PG show, right? I can say whatever the fuck I want. I'm gonna try to keep this fucking short. I've been wrestling over 18 years. 18 goddamn years, that's a long ass time. the 17th country to have WrestleMania.
The 3-day WrestleCon event actually culminated with Pete Dunne versus Chris Hero at the Vodafone Comedy Festival in Galway. That's a real thing, that happened, you can look that up. But from the heroes to the... Do I have to? From the heroes to the villains, we're going to talk about Marty Scurll and the night that he teamed up with Jordan Devlin to take on Will Ospreay and Ryan Smile, the Uptown Funkers. That was the headline of our Invasion Super Show, and that won't be the only time that we see that particular card on the list tonight, nor will it be the only time that we see Will Ospreay on the card tonight either. So, Uptown Funkers versus Marty Scurll and Jordan Devlin. Let's have a look.
Here at OTT.
reaction this man draws as a self-professed villain is unrivaled. He wants you to hate him, and yet you can't help but love him.
Turn his back on the fans and join the social elite with Paul Tracy.
I hate to say it, Angle, but I can totally see where he's coming from. His issue is that he is a world-respected athlete, and yet OTT continually look over him for the big matches. Just look at this one, Angle. He's in the ring with three imports. He's the only Irish wrestler in the main event. If that doesn't prove Jordan Devlin's point, I don't know what does.
Well, you could certainly argue that it's a mission accomplished, all right. Look at a guy who has done so much in the world of professional wrestling, achieved so much over in Japan as well on his various tours there. And, you know, Don, I guess you've got a point in that he's got a long history with Paul Tracy. He walked into Paul Tracy's gym in Bray, County Wicklow, 14 years ago to commence his training. That is a 14-year history of allegiance to that man. And the cries of "You sold out" echo around the Tivoli. Don, grab the roof.
Here comes the party.
Grab the roof. I don't think it's going to last long. Say hello to the man who broke the internet, Will Ospreay.
You will have this song stuck in your head for the next 2 weeks. Guaranteed. Let's bring and smile. Deal down, focus.
No one has a better time at OTT than the Uptown Funkers. It is so amazing to see this team reunited for another headline main event show tonight. The show stealer himself, Brian Smile. The most talked about.
I got a conga angle. Here we go.
The conga line starts his lap of the ring here at the Tivoli. The most talked about man in the world of professional wrestling, Will Ospreay, leading the charge. As opponents, Brian Smile and Will Ospreay put on what was arguably the most memorable match in OTT history. And now, they've combined their powers to take over.
What is this man made of?
Gesturing to the ward section as they wake their way into the ring. OTT superfan Al Byrne dancing away. Don't believe it, just
the sentence to you, you will never see Ryan smile, Will Ospreay in the war section, do the Macarena in the wrestling ring. They're a damn liar.
This is wrestling, Don. Someone's gonna start a Dance Forever chant.
Totally swept up in the moment, but I want you to consider this. How much seething rage is flowing through the veins of Jordan Devlin right now?
Oh, they've lit the fuse. There's no question about it. They have lit the fuse. Things are about to blow up here real, real soon.
Like I said, the fuse has been lit. Jordan Devlin wants this shut off right now. He wants the party stopped. I don't think that was a smart angle.
If you took a box of bees and stuck it in a cage of rattlesnakes and wrapped it in a ball of rats and gave it a good old rattle, that's about how angry Jordan Devlin is right now.
We're gonna hear from the villain. Whether they mean to or not, this crowd with their cheers of Ospreay might hurt him.
Don't be so rude, then put your chance in for the best wrestler we ever had.
Jesus Christ.
know how much your mum likes roleplay.
Tivoli thinks they just had 6-7 minutes of fun. This is awesome chant now. What they don't realize is every second of that was taunting Jordan Devlin. Even his own tag team partner, Marty Scurll, got a reaction, got a positive bit of cheering when he came out. Jordan Devlin now feels more isolated than ever.
He turned his back on the crowd, though.
And the exact reason that he turned his back on the crowd was because of this, because the crowd only chants for the imports and they don't appreciate the homegrown talent like Jordan Devlin.
I think it's a huge amount of respect for the talent of Jordan Devlin's success all around the world. Dominant performer over in Japan, and now returned here to Ireland to OTT. But just because they respect him doesn't mean they have to like him.
Smile and Ospreay are two of the most gifted wrestlers in the world. But Devlin resents the fact that they take this so lightly. Partying on the way to the ring. You gotta give it to Ryan Smile. He teased, he taunted, and eventually capitalized on Jordan.
He's in for the pin.
1, 2, oh! Just a count of one this time. Quickly, quick escape there from Jordan Devlin.
Devlin eats an elbow.
Huge shot from Ryan Smile.
Oh, and a massive kick to the head. And you're right, Don. Ryan Smile's enjoying himself.
We may be dealing with an issue that Jordan Devlin is over angry. He has seen him enraged so much that he's not thinking straight. And that's why he's falling into these traps laid for him by Ryan.
Ospreay flying early.
They don't call him the aerial assassin for nothing.
Off the top rope, driving that fist into the shoulder of Jordan Devlin. Oh, I'm talking on it now. Play of athleticism here from Jordan Devlin.
Oh, closed fist. That shows the aggression of this new look Jordan Devlin. Standing Hurricane Rana.
Followed by a dropkick. And that's how dangerous Will Ospreay is.
He can beat you down in a second. Might be time to see what Marty Scurll's bringing to the table tonight.
This crowd wants the villain in the ring.
Yes, Here comes the villain.
Marty Scurll glowering at Will Ospreay.
I think there's a certain irony here that Scurll likes to employ the chicken wing, and there's a move in Ospreay's overall regime called the Cheeky Nando's. So there's a lot of poultry moves going on here.
Marty Scurll working that wrist lock.
Saw a lot of this earlier with Dunn and Sabre Jr. Like I said before, it doesn't matter how well conditioned you are, your fingers are still vulnerable. But look at this!
The diversionary tactics of Will Ospreay as he escapes. Headlock takeover into the head scissors from Ospreay.
Unbelievable chain wrestling. You will not see better chain wrestling than that anywhere in the world tonight. No better than here in the Tivoli at OTT. Jordan Devlin looking to get involved now. From Will Ospreay saying, I didn't need to hit you there, but I could have if I wanted to.
Toying with the villain, which is a dangerous, dangerous tactic, and he eats a kick to the gut for his troubles. Ospreay from headlock to hammerlock.
Oh!
Yeah! Rolls in the shoulder tackle again, takes Ospreay off his feet.
That's what Will Ospreay is all about.
Ospreay using the ropes to his advantage. Cartwheeling out!
Scurll goes for the standing hurricane rana. Ospreay says, have you scouted, bro? I've got you scouted like a wonder kid on Football Manager.
Proving elusive. Devlin trying to get involved, eats a kick. Oh, a pair of double boots. Oh, both men eat a clothesline. Drop kick.
Surround sound drop kicks from the Uptown Funkers.
Toss. Dancing into kicks. Oh!
Oh my god! Did you see the impact on either side? Both of Devlin's temples eating drop kicks from the Uptown Funkers.
Devlin's head nearly exploded like a watermelon. Marty Scurll about to get the same treatment. Oh, double poke to the eyes.
Well scouted from Scurll.
He's living up to the villain moniker.
There's a lot of gyrating in this match.
That's going to affect your Saturday night.
Is there anything worse than getting an elbow to the face? Yes. The guy dabbing before he shoves his elbow in your face.
Snapmare to kick to the base of the skull. Just a two count on this occasion. Ospreay regroups. Makes the tag to Ryan Smile.
Marnell taking out the arm of the villain. Devlin unable to reach. This must just be making Jordan Devlin so mad. Exactly what he had an issue with. Like I said before, the boys we bring in from overseas, main event shows, when all he gets to do is watch. Right now, he's literally watching from the apron.
Well, I think he's going to get his chance to get very involved very quickly. And he might be sorry he does. Ryan Smile thrown to the outside. Mighty score with a kick from the apron.
And Devlin takes out Will Ospreay.
Sound of that kick echoing around the Tivoli. Ryan Smile is in a bad way here, Don.
Right on the ring apron. You know, well documented. It's the hardest part of the ring. It's not where you want to get slammed.
The steel supports run straight through there. Taking a beat down here in the corner from the villain.
This is where the villain's strong. He's got his opponent grounded and he can plan his next move. Very calculated. Devlin and this girl working as a very effective unit at the moment. You wouldn't think this is the first time they tag together.
These guys have been around the world. They've seen it all. They've done it all. They've done it on the biggest stages. Here around Europe, across the United States, as far afield as Japan. Oh, Ryan Smile is nearly broken.
He ragdolled right down on the ring off that turnbuckle.
Ryan Smile hasn't moved yet.
That could be all.
And it's lucky that the aerial assassin makes it in time for the save, because Ryan Smile is in a whole world of danger here. Chop, which grounds Ryan Smile.
There's not many men who can take down an opponent to the mat with a chop. That's impressive from the villain.
Sweeps the leg. Ryan Smile is just out of tagging distance there, the aerial assassin Will Ospreay.
This is where the villain's so effective. Taunting the tag partner.
Driving those knees into the floor. Oh, Will Ospreay eats an elbow. A huge kick to the head. Ryan Smile just makes it out in time, but he's in a world of hurt here, Don.
Crowd trying to get behind Ryan Smile. He's clearly in trouble here.
Another huge blow to the head. You've got to feel like Ryan Smile needs to make the tag to get out, recuperate, refresh himself, and be ready to come back and contribute later on in this match, because at the moment, he is in a very bad way.
Jordan Devlin smartly taking the ref away.
Referee Nile Fox distracted Jordan Devlin. Right between the eyes of Ryan Smile.
Very smart shot in there. Some will call it cheap, I call it smart.
Backbreaker from the villain. It just discards him. Throwing him to the ground like a piece of rubbish.
Devlin coming in with Ryan Smile at his mercy. Devlin's a professional athlete. That'll roll right off his back.
Oh, makes it out in time, and Ryan Smile crashes into his temple again.
One, two, three. Those two counts are getting longer. If Smile doesn't tag out soon, Devlin and Skrull could have their day in the sun.
Ryan Smythe is so disoriented, he's reaching for Marty Skrull to make the tag. He doesn't know where he is. This is a bad, bad situation for Ryan Smythe.
Watch. This is how effective the villain and the social elite member, Jordan Devlin, are as a team.
Cheap shot to Will Ospreay from Devlin again. Ryan Smythe somehow finds a way to escape at the back.
Fuck you!
Ooh, all the way to the outside. What an evasive! Oh my god!
Desperation move from Ryan Smythe as he lands the enziguri.
Smythe just may have turned this match on its head. Devlin thought he had a clothesline all wrapped up. He funks his way out of it. It's like funk dancing for self-defense.
So Will Ospreay gets the crowd going. Ryan Smythe needs to make this tag right now. He's come to.
Unbelievable enziguri from Ospreay, but it doesn't bring Devlin to his, to the floor. He stays on his feet.
From across the ring, charges.
Oh! Huge kick. But Devlin is fighting back to his feet.
Aerial Assassin is getting ready. Jumps, springs. Devlin isn't home. Oh, double boots.
Team is on.
Looks to clothesline. Springboard.
Oh my god!
Somersaulting overhead kicks.
Is Jordan Devlin the kick out? Will Ospreay is giving almost everything he has. There's not too many tricks he has up his sleeve left.
As he listens to the crowd chant his name, Will Ospreay is getting ready to finish this. Sizing up Jordan Devlin. Forearm of his own, but takes a boot. Ospreay bouncing through the ropes. And another kick to the head.
Oh my god! Shooting star press to the outside, and he lands on his feet.
Going up high again. Makes the tag. Oh, and another kick.
He's got Devlin propped up here.
And the villain Marty Skrull makes the save.
Saves the match for his team. This is unbelievable, Angus. This action's as good as we've seen here at OTT. Taking on Devlin and Skrull at the same time.
Just kidding.
Oh, just kidding.
Devlin almost taking the head off Ospreay. Skrull with a knee followed by a kick to the face.
Oh my god! The cutter off the top rope. And Skrull right back to his feet. That was unbelievable from Jordan Devlin. And Smythe manages not only to kick out, but get up to his feet as the crowd chants OTT at their damn right angle.
Ryan Smythe is a very special talent.
Oh, we might be about to see the chicken wing.
Smythe rolls out through the legs. Can't quite finish the pin. Ospreay, and another to Skrull.
Oh god, he lands it! Oh my god! What did we just see?
We just saw the greatest wrestler in the world.
What an unbelievable sequence of offense from all four of these men. stage has flipped.
We talk about guys putting their bodies on the line in their offenses here, but no one comes close to the aerial assassin Will Ospreay.
That forearm from the top rope, and now he's getting a chop and a smack to the face for his trouble.
The villain unloading on Will Ospreay.
Oh!
Ospreay has him tied up in the ropes.
Oh! We're about to see Cheeky Nando's, but he drop kicks out of it. Big boot, he takes a scroll. He's going for it, the ass cutter.
Oh no!
Hit him with the chicken wing! He's got the chicken wing locked in! Ospreay was trying to hit the ass cutter, but now he's in the chicken wing!
Smile rolls him out!
Oh, he's going back in! Unbelievable!
Ryan Smile's unaware. Jordan Devlin with the intercept.
He's got the half grab on Ryan Smile.
Single leg.
Don Bunkers in submissions.
Will Ospreay is in a world of trouble here. I think he's about to tap Don. He can't withstand this for much longer.
They're both in trouble. One of them's got to give.
Ryan Smile doesn't have anything left in the tank here.
They're helping each other out. This is amazing.
Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
Ospreay makes the rope. The chant of "Yes, we can" reverberates around this jam-packed Tivoli Theatre.
Look at Devlin bashing his own head off the turnbuckle.
And these 10 funkers have made it out, but at what cost, Don?
He's getting frustrated. Skrull and Devlin are calculated individuals. They're planning something to put this match to bed, and soon.
I think the Uptown Funkers are spent. I think they've given all they have to give. The support of this crowd lift their spirits and get them back in the game.
Oh my god.
Unfortunately those two suplexes would suggest otherwise.
What could they possibly be planning here?
Whatever it is, it spells trouble for the Uptown Funkers.
Surround sound from Ospreay and from Smile.
Ryan Smile takes flight! And it's carnage here at the Tivoli. Bodies everywhere. From the top. The villain gets the knees up.
I hope this match never ends, Angus.
Will Ospreay doesn't live on Earth. He just shows up on Earth to go to the gym and wrestle the greatest matches any of us ever get to see.
Ospreay and Smile didn't need Ryanair. They flew here themselves. What about the resilience of Devlin and Skrull still in it after all that offense?
Devlin stalking Ospreay now.
This is what Devlin's been wanting. Oh my god, forearm to the face. It gives him right back.
Calling each other on. These sick bastards are enjoying this, Don.
Not even attempting to block. They want to see what each other have.
Headbutt to the face. Devlin's down.
Oh! Oh my god!
No, Devlin back is. He slammed him!
A sick pile driver! Skrull! Huge clothesline!
No, they dropped him on his head again.
Good.
And somehow, from somewhere,
is saved
again. Ryan Smile finds it to drive through and save his partner.
This crowd are on their feet and with every reason, Angle.
Ospreay has no idea where he is. He's out. Ospreay slammed at the top of his head again and again.
What more could these men give?
I don't know. We've seen this from the villain before.
Oh! Oh my God! If that isn't two or three broken fingers, I don't know what.
A sickening crack, turning the stomach of the audience here. You hear the chant.
They're expressing their opinion. I can't say I disagree, but that's not necessarily a bad thing in this match. Double super kick. Devlin tags himself in.
Devlin taking flight, but eats a double super kick off the top rope. And surely that's the end. Will Ospreay looks like a man with bad intentions.
Oscar, he's been looking for that all match. He finally hit the ass cutter. Smile's going up top. Oh, that's gotta be it.
You want to talk about promotions around the world? You want to talk about the state of European wrestling at the moment? OTT is showing the world how it's done. OTT is leading the charge. OTT is making the most exceptional nights of wrestling entertainment anywhere on the planet.
As justified as I thought Jordan Devlin was in his cause, it looks like there's just no overcoming the strength in numbers of the Uptown Funkers. That teamwork and athleticism is unmatched. But what a showing from Marty Skrull and from Jordan Devlin.
600 people on their feet, funking it up with the Uptown Funkers.
God, I missed the tilly. You know, that was only the very beginning of the upward trajectory we'll all see Jordan Devlin enjoy over the coming months as he started to take on international superstars, everyone from Chris Hero to Matt Riddle. He started to get this name for himself, the Import Killer. But along that streak, I think my personal favorite match was against a man named Moose. So to finish off part one of our Gems from the Tivoli, I'd like you all to enjoy Jordan Devlin versus Moose. So the time is now. The cans have beer. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your part one main event. The Import Killer, Jordan Devlin versus Moose.
His way to the ring from Bray County Wicklow, weighing at 180 pounds. He is Jordan Devlin!
A man whose star continues to shine brighter and brighter every single day. Every time we see this man in the OTT ring, he looks more impressive. He wrestles more impressively. He has new styles of aggression to unleash on his opponents. And tonight, he could be coming up against one of the biggest styles clashes that he has ever encountered. We have seen Jordan Devlin take it to big men like Big Damo in the past. But tonight, up against Moose, this will be one of his biggest challenges that he's ever faced.
I was approached by Jordan Devlin before the show tonight. He made it very clear to me that he recently competed in front of 10,000 people at a sold-out Key Arena here in Dublin for WWE. He was so energized back in the tournament tonight. It's going to need to be, because he's got a mad mountain to scale now in the shape of the Moose.
If you're watching at home, it's hard to overstate the size of this man. I shook his hand earlier, his finger went up to my elbow.
From Moose Station, weighing in at 300 pounds, he is Moose!
The reigning Impact Grand Champion has made his way to the Tivoli.
Did you hear Butch? I mean, I don't often listen to him, but I picked up on what he said there. Jordan Devlin weighing in at 180 pounds. Moose weighing in at 300 pounds. Jordan giving up 120 pounds, which is two-thirds of his body weight.
No doubt about it, we're in David and Goliath territory.
Devlin is the perennial David. He just looked over to me and said, oh, he's a big boy, but he did not look phased. We've seen mooses, we've seen wolves. Have we seen any more animals? Stranger things have happened.
And the last thing Jordan Devlin loves here is to get locked into a power battle with this 300-pound former NFL standout. He's going to need to use pace, aggression, tactics, and that hard-hearted streak. That is not the soul of Jordan Devlin.
Well, the best thing about what you just said is that Jordan's strengths are, in fact, pace, aggression, and tactics. Don't get me wrong, Moose is an intimidating figure. I've never seen Jordan Devlin intimidated.
Stay standing off the shoulder tackle. And he just bounces off Moose.
There you go. Take the big man off his game, Devlin.
Like we said, getting into a power struggle here is not going to be the way to go. Look at the agility, Don.
Oh my God! Moose is one of the tallest superstars I've ever seen in this ring. Jordan Devlin just hit a hurricane runner from a standing start. And another!
Oh! That could be it.
No, surely not. Come on, Devlin, we need you.
Both boots brought up the jaw of Moose. Look at the agility of the 300-pounder!
I'll give you that was impressive.
Jesus Christ, Doug. If he can move like that with that much power, what the hell is Jordan Devlin going to do to try and get past him?
Why don't you let Devlin worry about that? There you go. He worried about it.
Falcon standout is in a world of danger here with the back rake. Jordan Devlin. Sometimes, Don, when an athlete crosses over from the NFL, they might be looked at in a certain way. Don't forget Moose, the PWA Rookie of the Year in 2015. This guy's not here trading an NFL reputation. This guy is the champ because he deserves it. As we said, reigning Impact Grand Champ. What an incredible athlete.
Moose here getting rid of those gloves. Just
doused his hand in vodka or whiskey or something.
Oh dear God.
Well, that fans will get that chair back anytime soon.
This does not bode well for Devin.
Uh-oh.
Close quarters. Devin here kicking his head off. Like an articulated Larry.
Devlin using that pace, that agility.
When he slow moves down here, he has to capitalize that. He's been targeting that knee. He's chopping down a mighty oak. The only way to stop this giant is to put him down like that.
That's a speciality of Jordan Devlin.
Slingshot cutter out of nowhere from Devlin, and is that enough?
Signature from Devlin. Moose kicking out at barely two. If Devlin hit me with that, I wouldn't be awake before WrestleRama.
Moose is loosened up here, I guess. Eating forearm after forearm.
Devlin getting frustrated here, and I don't blame him.
The shot's almost taking more out of Devlin than they are out of Moose. That's clearly terrifying.
Sick impact on that kick. Still, Moose is on one knee.
Left after left. Rocking the jaw of death.
He's tuning something up here. A high knee.
A knee. Lances with a huge kick. Manhandling Devlin.
Moose can move for a big man.
300 pounder running amok here.
The height he got on that.
Check if Devlin's head is still connected.
And a kick out by the OTT standout star, Jordan Devlin. He's still in this and he's not going to lay down. Yes, OTT crowd, there is Moose. I get it. That kick from Devlin before, and now chopping down the big sequoia tree.
Still only to one knee though, Don. Oh no, he's got him high.
Look at the power.
Where's he going? Jesus, where's he going? Dear God, they've killed him.
Oh my God, Jordan's dead.
Jordan Devlin is in the fifth row of the raised stage area, and he's not moving, Don.
Tossing 180 pounds like it was nothing.
What's he doing?
Oh my God!
Right cross body from the stage into the ring.
How impressive was that? Down him now. And he's calling for it. He wants to finish it now with the package pile driver.
Brain buster on the 300 pound NFL star.
But I still can't get over Moose tossing Jordan Devlin into the fifth row. And within moments, Jordan Devlin launching his entire body weight over the top rope and taking out Moose in the process. amazing. There's one for the OTT highlight reel. And listen to this. These fans finally giving Jordan Devlin the credit he deserves. Finally realizing that this is the OTT standout star.
Tyler High moonsault, no one home, but he lands it. Senton from the 300 pounder.
Oh, wait a second.
For the second, moonsault.
And Devlin lives. This is unbelievable.
You want to ask what sets Jordan Devlin apart? You want to ask what put him on the radar at WWE? Look no further than this match. Jordan Devlin is as real as it gets.
And a sit down!
And still Jordan Devlin fights back.
I don't know how much more of this I can take, let alone Devlin.
Irish wrestling is in a very special place right now. And that man is a massive part of the reason why.
And these fans, louder and louder by the minute, getting behind Jordan Devlin. This is bizarre.
Moose playing the turnbuckle now. This does not bode well for Devlin, who lands the head kick.
Jordan Devlin with the big kick. What's he going for here? Uh-oh.
Whatever it is, it's not good. My God.
That's got to be it. Kick out of one. Moose kicks out of one.
Moose is inhuman, he's a monster.
Devlin looking for another brainbuster, he's got it.
The second to the top, moonsault.
Picture perfect. 1, 2, 3. What a showing from Jordan Devlin.
550 rabid Irish wrestling fans on their feet.
In over 20 years, watching this fantastic sport, only a very, very few amount of times have I seen a crowd disdain, absolutely hate a man at the beginning of a match, and stand up and give him a standing ovation by the end. We have just witnessed something special, and this could be a huge moment in the career of that fine young man, Jordan Devlin.
Someone needs to find out what they put in the water in Bray County Wicklow. Because pound for pound, it may well be the greatest stable in the world of professional wrestling.
We asked the question, how long before Mark Haskins is in the championship picture here at OTT? The same has to be asked about Jordan Devlin. Somehow, month by month, our title scene gets hotter. More contenders show up and line up for a shot at that belt. And there's something big in the future of that man, Jordan Devlin.